Hello children, hope you are good and doing well at your home and at the same time enjoying your online classes also. So yesterday I gave you a work and most of you have sent me it over WhatsApp. So nice of you, and keep doing your work like this in the future also, right? So we will go further in more into the chapter and we will deal with some more subordinate conjunctions. Right, we have learnt a series of, or we have come across a lot many subordinate conjunctions, where a few has been explained yesterday and day before yesterday. Today we will be learning about few more. Right, so if and unless is what we are going to learn today. We are going to learn about these two subordinate conjunction. Apart from that, there are some more which are coming. So first thing first, let us first start with this. If and unless are used to suggest a condition. So whenever we use either if or unless as subordinate conjunction, why we use this? We use to suggest a condition. Now what kind of condition? It's important that we know, or we should be able to understand the condition, right? For that, instead of going from the beginning, what we will do today we will see the example first and then try to understand what actually it means, right? So the example over here, it says that I will win the game unless my racket breaks, right? So I will win the game unless my racket breaks. So something that has to happen afterwards. Because of using unless, whatever is the reason or the condition, what will happen? This person will win it if this does not happen. So that is why, or here is where we use unless. Now let us read these three lines. Use unless when you mean something could be true. Something could be true if something that follows after unless does not happen first. So what it says, something that follows after unless, something that follows after unless, in this case what is following after unless? My racket breaks, right? Does not happen first. If this happens first, then this is not going to happen. In such cases we are supposed to use unless, right? So that is why we are trying to understand this in a different way. First the example and then this, otherwise it will be little difficult for us to understand from here and then apply it over here. We need to remember the example to use unless, or in order to learn the use of unless, we have to have one example set in our mind from beforehand, right? What it says does not happen first. If this does not happen, then he or she is going to surely win, right? So in such cases we are supposed to write unless. Now next, in next also we will have to do the same thing. First we will have to read the example and then we will go down to see the explanation or understand the explanation. Here it says, I will win the game if my racket does not break. See, both the sentence means the same, but here unless and here if. Conjunction unless is used, here conjunction if is used. So my racket does not break. So what it says over here, use if when you mean something, when you mean something could be true if something follows after if something follows after it. Over here what follows? My racket does not break. After if happens first. So if this happens first, then this is not going to happen. In that case we are going to use if, right? So over here, I will win the game, and whatever is followed by if, whatever is followed after if happens first, this is going to be true. This is going to be true if this does not happen, right? So this is going to be true. In that case, we are supposed to write if. There is one small thing that you can remember: does not or not will come. Dash, and then in the next part of the sentence, not will come. So in most of the cases, whenever not comes, if is applicable, right? In C, not has come. So this is another way to remember when to use if. In most of the cases, you will use if as a conjunction if there is not. So in that case, what happens? This is true and this is the follower of if, right? So these are the two examples. Number one is unless, number two is if. The use of unless and if. Conjunctions though, although, and still are used to connect ideas that contrast. The other day I explained you what is the meaning of contrast. It is a white sheet of paper and on that there is a red line or red mark. So both are contrasting. Why? Because white sheet of paper is light in color and red is deep in color. So connect ideas that contrast. So though, although, and still are the three subordinating conjunctions which connects ideas and contrast. So let us see an example. I think there are two examples. I am sorry, although it was not entirely my fault. You are sorry, but you know it is not your fault entirely, but still you are contrasting. Why would you be sorry when you have not committed mistake? But here, I am sorry, although it was not entirely, the whole mistake was not mine, but still I am sorry. So contrasting fact, I am sorry. If you are not wrong, then why should you be sorry? Right? So in those cases, we use subordinating conjunctions like though, although, and still. So here, although it was not entirely my mistake, Mary had to go to Agra. Still, she came to meet us. Still, she came to meet us. Over here, what is still doing? Still is again connecting ideas that contrast. Mary, you see, must be busy or must be occupied to get ready to go to Agra, but still she took out some time to meet them. Contrasting. When you are busy, you don't have time to do something which is not very important, right? But here you see the contrasting idea, and still is been used to support that contrast. Okay, next, conjunction because, since, and as are used to connect the result of something with its reason or causes. Remember, reason, result of reason or causes, right? For example, what will be the reason? Like I am wearing sweater, or say suppose I was wearing a sweater, what would be the reason behind that? I am wearing jacket because it is cold. So reason or cause. Say for example, I have switched on the AC. I have switched on the AC as it was hot. So it basically talks about reasons or causes, right? So let us see an example. But before that, use of so. So is another subordinating conjunction. So connects results or decision. So result, what would be the result? Right, I have prepared well for my examination, so my result will be good, right? So this is an example where we use so for what? Results or decision, right? Let us see one example. There is water in the field because it rained whole night. So over here you see the reason why there is water. It is not talking about a result, right? Result will be somebody, for example, if it rains whole night, then there will be water in the field. That is the result. Over here, it is the reason. Today you are seeing that there is water in the field. So over here, since it is a reason, that's why we have used, or because it's been used over here. So these are the few examples of subordinating conjunctions. What are the subordinating conjunctions that we learned today? Number one being if, unless. These are the two subordinating conjunctions that we have learned. Then we came down to learn about though, although, and as. After that, we came down to learn about because, since, and as. Right? And lastly we learnt about so. So what will be your task today? You got to read page number, read page number, let me check the page number, 97 and 98. Read page number 97 and 98. I'm not giving you any task today. You don't have to do anything today, because tomorrow when we will come into the class, that is the time when I'm going to give you a task, right? So no task today. During this online class only, between 9 to 10 a.m., you please read all of these things from your book, from page number 97 and 98. Till then, bye-bye and take good care of yourself.